Hi everyone, and welcome to our video on the newest developments in contact lenses for treating colorblind deficiencies. In this video, we'll be talking about the basics of how we see color, the mechanisms behind red-green colorblindness, some treatments for colorblindness, and finally focusing on new research on contact lenses that enhance color vision for people with red-green colorblind deficiency. So, how do we see color? Colors are expressed in the reflection of light waves in different wavelengths. There is a wave spectrum chart that shows the different wavelengths, and specifically the wavelengths that humans can see. Humans can see visible light in the 400 to 700 nanometer wavelength range. Humans see color by interpreting light through the retina of the eye. The retina is located in the back of the eyeball. The retina is made up of a combination of cones and rods. Color is interpreted using red, green, and blue cones from the retina. For example, if there was a blue object in the room, the light from the environment is reflected from the light source, off of the blue object, and into the retina of the eye. The blue cones in the retina of the eye are activated and sends a signal to the brain signifying that the object is blue. So, what would happen if one of our cones stopped working? This is where colorblindness comes in. There are many different types of colorblindness, but this video will specifically talk about red-green colorblindness. Red-green colorblindness is where shades of green resemble closer to shades of red. This condition primarily affects males and is induced by a genetic mutation. There are two types of red-green colorblindness, protoanomaly and deuteranomaly. Protoanomaly is when individuals have a reduced sensitivity to red light, so they have difficulty in distinguishing between different shades of red and green. The red cones are affected here. Deuteranomaly is more common, where there is a reduced sensitivity to green light, causing confusion and mistaking red and green for each other. The green cones are affected here. This leads us to different types of treatments that have been developed for this deficiency. In the past, there have been inchroma glasses, which are made of minerals that filter out the wavelengths between green and red. These wavelengths block some of the light rays that come through the glasses so that the overlap of red and green wavelengths are reduced. This allows for the connection between the brain and the signal to be clearer, and the brain can decipher between the two colors. Although it provides a clear signal to the brain, it does not completely solve color blindness, and they may not be able to see the equivalent of natural color vision. There has been research in recent developments in contact lenses as a colorblind deficiency treatment to improve the filtration of light wavelengths and receiving signals. A research study published in March 2023 by a group of scientists aimed to create contact lenses that only cover the pupil of the eye and could filter wavelengths of light effectively. The pupil is the part of the eye that perceives light, and past contact lenses that have been made cover the entire surface of the eye with tint, which make the wearers uncomfortable and draws attention to their deficiency. This study found that the lenses effectively filtered light in the range of 530 to 590 nanometers, and they work better in enhancing color perception and providing comfort. These lenses also were better at filtering specific wavelengths compared to other color vision deficiency wearable devices. The study was carried out using 3D printing of molds to mimic the average pupil size of adults, and different concentrations of ink were used for the tint of the contact lenses. There are a total of 4 tinted lenses with different concentrations to block different amounts of light. The higher the concentration of ink, the more light was blocked. The results of this study demonstrated that the performance evaluation of the tinted lenses effectively filtered the light in the overlapping region between the red and green photoreceptor cones. The developed contact lenses had better selective color filtering properties than the commercial wearable ones. It is important to note that there are implications to this research. Since this research is extremely new, there's a lot more research needed to be done to ensure that users are able to wear the lenses and that the ink dye does not leak on the lens. There also needs to be more research done on the safety of wearing the lenses before commercializing them. With all this new upcoming research on contact lenses for colorblindness, there is a promising future in how we treat colorblind deficiencies. This research may be the start of finding out how to treat other kinds of colorblindness and help people who have this deficiency live a more comfortable and colorful life. Thanks for watching.